religion. No, we're the Hebrew Israelites. We're here today to wake up our people to cause trouble in Israel. The Negroes are Eastern descent. So-called Negroes, so-called Hispanic, the so-called Native American Indians. We're here to wake up our people, which they are going to elect the only region. We're here to reach the elect, we're here to edify, we're here to condemn the society, man. Okay? Because we're on the last day. See these signs of the blood moon, we're going to break that out. See, you know, constant thing with the Ebola, which the apostles I've been talking about, we're going to break that down. Alright? You see, brothers who saw for the truth, and you niggas like eyesores bugging the fuck out of both sides beating you up, man. Right?
Yeah, that nigga's done.
Yeah, man. Because this dude, you got brothers coming to truth, right? And that's why the Most High had to bring brothers of truth to make example of that you're not part of the elect, man. I'm not saying I'm part of the elect, Lord willing, hopefully I am, the brother Shackadon, and the brothers do the work truthfully and digitally, but you got brothers that's going saying that the Yahweh Shai don't exist, man. You bugging the fuck out, man. The Most High gonna kill you, man. That's why he's reading you out, because why? He make example of you, not to be niggas, not to trust niggas like you, man. Alright? That's why when you left the camp, you started bugging out, man. Then you had John Quash. The next thing you know, you left, you're against him now. You know, he's talking all this nonsense, man. You know, we don't got time for that, man. I wrote a comment on your board saying, wake the fuck up, nigga. You bugging the fuck out, man. The time is near, man. And you bugging out. You gone, man.
Yeah, when a dude reject Yahweh Shai, that's it.
Yeah, man. Blasphemy, man.
When the Lord taking that name out your mouth, that's it. Game. It's one thing to go off on a Gentile. Right. It's one thing not to see the chick right now.
Right.
Which we made tons of videos and other brothers. The mark of the beast is a chip. Some dudes may see it later on. But when you believe in Yahweh Shai and all of a sudden you stop believing in him, that's game. That's game, man. The Lord weeded you out, man.
Game over, man.
Game over. Like them other guys that can't see the Gentiles or the chip, they still have the foundation, which is Yahweh Shai.
Right.
And the Lord may make them see it, or he may make them not see it.
Right.
But when you reject Yahweh Shai, the foundation, there's no hope for you.
Right, because the video that the Apostle Ramah made, saying that the Most High will make men see certain things now, or maybe later, or maybe not at all, until the kingdom.
Acts chapter 18. Damn right. Allah don't exist, man. We get Acts chapter 18, verse 24. It says, and a certain Jew named Apollos, born at Alexandria, an eloquent man and mighty in the scriptures, came to Ephesus. This man was instructed in the way of the Lord, and being fervent in the spirit, he gave and taught diligently the things of the Lord, not only the baptism of John.
Right. So this man was apostle in the scriptures, man. And the Most High put the spirit on him to be a powerful man, man. Which is a powerful prophet. Alright? John the Baptist.
Not only the baptism of John.
Not only the baptism of John. Alright, go on.
So what that mean, like the brother said, he was powerful in the scriptures, but he only knew the baptism of John. He didn't know the baptism of Yahweh Shai yet. So this expounding on what we talked about before, certain men, the Most High, they hope something they understand later on. Because Apollos is mighty, but he's still in the scriptures. We're going to read on. And he began to speak boldly in the synagogue, and when Aquila and Priscilla had heard, they took him unto them and expounded unto him the way of the Most High more perfectly.
Right. So these men came to him, okay, and then they taught him more about who the Most High, man. But he said he only knew about John the Baptist. All right, go on.
He says, And when he was disposed, the passage of Achaia and brethren wrote, exhorted the Jews to receive him, whom when he was come helped them much more have believed through grace. And for he mightily convinced the Jews that publicly showing by the scriptures that Yahushua was Christ.
Right. So after he knew, now he starts pondering on Yahushua. Many people call Christ today. Right?
So that showed you that he was powerful in the scriptures, but he didn't know everything at that time.
Right.
He still had to put up to the man up in Christ. He showed him the scriptures more perfectly. Right? He showed the scriptures more perfectly, and I think he broke it down to him, he understood. Then he went out there and taught that Yahushua was Christ. Or they went around eagerly called Jesus.
Right, so Jews. And that's why Most High gave certain men certain talents. Okay, he gave them certain talents to be a reader, to be a scriptologist, to stand post, to make videos, edit videos, you know, whatever it is. That the Most High,
I don't see many of your brothers around.
Men, huh? All right?
I don't see many of you around.
So that's why, that's why I saw, you know,
34,
he bugged
14.
Out. You know what I'm saying? He broke out. We got dudes like Azar who came to this truth, and all of a sudden, the Most High weeded him out for a reason.
Yeah.
Whatever that reason it is, it must be to show men.
So, coming to this truth,
you can be weeded out, man. All right? So.
Second Timothy 3:13. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse.
Read that again, huh?
Second Timothy 3:13. But evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived.
Right. So I saw, you know, he's deceiving, being deceived, man. He's deceiving the people, being deceived, man. He's teaching nonsense, man. He's teaching all this BS, you know, about the New Testament, which he was taught by the elders. Now he's going against the elders, and now he's blaspheming the Most High, man. So once you do that, it's a wrap, man. Game over. You're not supposed to do that, man. But you know, that's why the Most High put spirit on men to be examples of what to do and what not to do, man. All right? So that's, you know, like, he's not even getting on about the last days, man. He's just going against the scriptures. You know what I'm saying? He's going against the word of the Most High, man. That's what he's doing. He's going against the word of the Most High. You know? And he's not bringing out the last days, man. We started here today. We're on the last days. You know? You see about the thing about the Ebola, right? Which, we're going to talk about that in a few, all right? Yeah, this dude's not bringing up prophecies, man. Like, go on.
Right. He's not even getting on Esau.
Right.
Matthew 25:29. But everyone that hath shall be given, and he shall have abundance. But from him that hath not shall be taken away even that which he hath. And cast ye the profitable servant into utter darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth.
Right.
So the Lord is saying what? The very little that you had, the very knowledge that you had, he's going to take that away. And you see an example of a dude who's being destroyed right before your very eyes. Week after week, he's waxing worse and worse. Now you don't even believe in Yahushua. First of all, one of the kingdom called Jesus Christ is the foundation. And we ain't talking about that white devil that the Europeans put up in the Renaissance period, because that's not how the Lord looked like. That's not Christ in no way, man. Right? So, I saw he's waxing worse and worse. The Lord took his spirit away from you, man. And you're going to be destroyed.
And that's why, man. That's why I pray every day and night that the whole of the Most High don't forsake me in the last days, man. You need the Most High, man.
Not only the Most High, you need his son.
Yeah, his son. He's the one that gave up his life for us to come back to our ways, man.
Yeah, remember Atari?
Oh my goodness.
No, we said, what about Yahweh Shah? He said, no.
Yahweh showed me.
I was like,
he skipped on the mediator like this, like, woo. Like the Most High dealing with you, like he did with Moses, talk to him like, listen, son, you know, come on, man. This dude is real. That's why the elders got on his ass, man.
Wow. He's another one.
Definitely, man. The nigga's still, and then on the Far West, they're still under that mentality, man. They're still under that BS. Learn the history, you know what I'm saying? That's just true. But other things he's talking about is nonsense, man.
Yeah, when you go to hell,
he said
pop you in the butt.
And all these scriptures, man.
The homeland is Mesopotamia. Where you get that from, man? Why would the Most High send Abraham out of Babylon to go into the land of Canaan? That's the land that he promised Abraham. That's where the kingdom of heaven gonna be set up, huh? Or you want us to read that scripture? You're supposed to be an elder. You're supposed to know that. Oh, because it said the garden was most eastward in Eden. So all of a sudden, he automatically thinking that's Babylon. So first of all, the whole world at that time was a Pangeo, man. All the continents at that time was one. And when during the flood of Noah, that's when everything broke apart. But the whole land, the whole world was one, man, a globe. So based on your definition, because it says it was the most eastward, that means the garden should have been in China then. Because China is the most eastern country on the planet Earth. So where you get Babylon from, man? Let's talk about Jerusalem. Okay? That's why the Lord promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob that land. That's why Moses and Joshua had us going to the land of Canaan, man. That's when we got kicked out of the land. And that's why when the kingdom of heaven comes, we're going to get set back up in that land. The same land that he promised our fathers. Because that's where the garden, or Eden, or Eidon in Hebrew, that's where paradise was. Okay, it was never in no Mesopotamia. So I don't know who told you that. That you also fulfillment of that scripture I just read. The Lord took what you had. You don't know the basics. Jerusalem is the homeland, and you, I can't even, you.
And he wasn't coming out doing the work. Where his videos at? You know? Come on, man.
I'm gonna bring a script out. Nehemiah. Is it in Nehemiah?
But all of a sudden, you see, dude just popping out, man, all of a sudden, right? Just popping out of nowhere, man, like.
Yeah, we gotta bring our scriptures on what happens when you reject the outside. You gotta know Yahweh Shai is the foundation. And everything is about Yahweh, through Yahweh Shai. Everything is through Yahweh Shai, man. The Most High would always be the Most High. And we always worship the Most High, but through His Son. Like the Father Yahweh said, the Most High said, you gotta reverence, the same way you reverence me, you gotta reverence my Son. Because He's the one that died for you. So the same honor you give to the Father is the same honor. your son, you reject the father. Automatically talking back. Alright? Because like Yahweh Shai said, me and my father are one. Not the same being on entity, but they are on the same thing. So if you dishonor one, you dishonor both. Okay? Talking about he didn't fulfill the prophecy. You gotta go into a lot of things today, I'm saying. Because he's a demon, man.
All these things are coming out.
Yeah, that's good. Nehemiah 11 and 1. And the rulers of the people dwelt at Jerusalem. The rest of the people also cast lots to bring one of ten to dwell in Jerusalem, the holy city.
See? The holy city, man. The holy city. Right? So, what's with this Mesopotamia nonsense, man?
Mesopotamia. See if you see me.
In fact, let's pause.